I'm Mike Keith with General Manager John Robinson, and we're zooming some talking ball presented by Duncan. Coming off the Monday night win, 34-31 over Buffalo. John, I know it's been several days, but I don't know that I've recovered yet. That was a hard stop.
Yeah, I mean, talk about an exciting night of football for Nashville, for our fans. You know, just thinking back over it, it was really like a heavyweight boxing match. I mean, we traded blows back and forth. You know, Buffalo traveled well. They had fans there. You know, they would make a play and their fans would get loud. We'd make a play, our fans would get loud. But it was just really cool at the end when Derek broke off that long run to take the go-ahead score. Really well-blocked play. Give them the ball back, get it down on the goal line, and a fourth down stop, and Nissan Stadium just goes into complete pandemonium. I don't know that I've been a part of many exciting games like that one, Mike.
Okay, so some of your specific takeaways about the ball game, John. What did you take away from Monday night's win over the Bills?
Yeah, I mean, I think it was a really resilient game for our football team. You know, we knew that they were a top defense in the league. They were a high-octane offense. They've got a lot of great players. But we were going to have to be detailed. We were going to have to execute those details, that they were going to make some plays, and we were going to have to bounce back, you know, and I think that's what we did. We never panicked, even down there on the goal line stand. Like, we didn't panic. We executed, you know, a call that we've executed several times, and you know, a couple of individual efforts throughout the course of the night that really stood out as well.
Talk about A.J. Brown's individual efforts. 7 catches, 91 yards. A.J. got going in the second half. The passing game got going in the second half. John, what really fueled that in your opinion?
You know, I think we're able to build some play action stuff off the run game, Mike. Some of those strikes, some of those in cuts that, you know, A.J. has caught a lot in his time here. You know, he just did an outstanding job of breaking his route off at the top, creating some separation. The O-line did a good job of giving Ryan a pocket, and Ryan stood in there and stepped up and ripped it in there. And A.J. does what he's always done. You know, he throws his hands up there, he catches the football, he puts his foot in the ground and tries to get extra yards. And, you know, he really came up big for us in that second half.
Jeffrey Simmons is the guy who's getting a lot of attention following that game for the play at the goal line. Did an interview with Amy Wells after the game, and he said he'd really been pressing. He'd been trying too hard to make things happen. Then he just sort of took a deep breath, let the game come to him, and it really did, particularly in the fourth quarter. What have you seen from Big Jeff?
Yeah, I think, you know, in that game specifically, he got more comfortable with the scheme, with the way that they were trying to attack him and block him. You could see that he was playing with a little bit more violence, it seemed, every series, because he started to gain some familiarity with the scheme and the blocks and the goal line play down there at the end. It was just an outstanding individual effort on his part to knife in there and explode through cutoff block and force that sneak to come up short.
Let's talk about the fact that Monday Night Football is over. You've had a short week now to get ready for this weekend's game with the Chiefs. With everything that has gone on, injuries and such, how challenging has it been for this football team?
Yeah, I mean, we've been there before on short weeks, you know, whether it's a Thursday night or whatever it may be, but you know, on Tuesday, you come in, you take stock of the game. You know, you go through the injuries, you start to map out the practice plan of how many reps is this player going to get? Does this guy need an extra day of rest? Or, you know, you map that out. You know, we get the scouting report from the scouts. The coaches start to implement the various pieces of the game plan. You know, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, you're back on the grass, kind of in a normal routine, if you will. It's probably a little slower, Mike, because you have a little less time, you know, to kind of heal up after a tough game like that Buffalo game was. By the time you get to Saturday, you're working with some speed, you know, and you're really trying to fine tune the details. And it's been a good week.
Bottom line is, this is a tough football team, John. You got to be very proud of that.
Yeah, it is. And we've got another tough opponent this week. I mean, it's an explosive offense. You know, we know at Kansas City, we've played them. Seems like we've played them, you know, last couple years at least as well. So we know what they're capable of, but super proud of our football team and the way we've been able to continue to fight and stay resilient throughout the course of games.